So for super elevation, for mixed traffic, we are having this formula. V is equal to V square by 225 R. This formula is used for the mixed traffic only. Okay. This V is in kmph. 225 is a just a constant, and R is the radius of your, what you can say, curvature or radius of curve. So this is for mixed traffic only. Now, from where this 225 has came, in mixed traffic, we consider the 75% of the design speed only. Because in mixed traffic, what happens that your speed of the vehicle got reduced. So that's why we consider is 75% of the VD. V is equal to 75% of VD, means 0.75 multiplied by VD. So after calculation, this value comes. This is for mixed design. Then mixed traffic. Then second formula that we have seen for E. The value of E should always be less than or equal to 0.07. or 7% in the design of the your highways, in the geometric design of highways. Okay, so E is nothing but what? It is the rate of super elevation. Okay, or super elevation value in percentage. Okay, so this should always be less than the 7%. Now the third thing that we have seen is the value of F. F is nothing but coefficient of friction, and the formula for your F is V square by 127 R minus 0.07, which is the maximum value of super elevation that we have considered. Okay, so this is the basic formula for normal traffic. Okay, for normal traffic we are having this formula. F is equal to V square by 127 R minus 0.07. Now if you are having certain numerical in your exam regarding this type of super elevation and coefficient of friction, then how you will solve it? You will use this formula for that numerical, that is E plus F is equal to V square by 127 R. This is the formula that you can use when frictional coefficient is given, velocity is given in kmph, radius is given in meter. Then you can use this formula to calculate the value of E, that is the rate of super elevation. Or if value of E is given, then you can calculate the value of F, that is the coefficient of friction. This is the thing in our previous lecture we have seen. Then fifth thing that we have seen, that value of F should always be less than 0.15 for all type of designs. Okay, so value of coefficient of friction should always be less than 0.15. Okay, so one thing that you can note here, that value of E should be less than or equal to 0.07, and value of F also should be less than or equal to 0.15. then see this formula. Now E plus F, you make the addition of E plus F. 0.15 plus 0.07, that is the 0.22, means your value of E plus F, the sixth thing I will write it here. Your value of E plus F should be less than or equal to 0.22. Now all these formulas are useful for you in your examination also, and in the competitive examination such as the GATE, that is the Graduate Aptitude Test in Engineering. They also ask such type of formulas, or what you can say, multiple choice questions. Okay, so their MCQs are based upon this type of small formulas. Okay, so E plus F less than or equal to 0.22. Now from where this formula has came? this formula is not given in your book. You will not find this formula in any book. But I am giving you this formula as a shortcut formula. The value of E is should be less than 0.07. Value of F should be less than or equal to 0.15. Then E plus F is equal to 0.22. Now, you can equate this 0.22 with equal to V square by 127R here, right? The value of E plus F should not be more than 0.22. So that's why equate this value. Here you can equate this value 0.22 with equal to V square by 127R, right? So you will get the value of V, that is the V allowable. That is the allowable maximum velocity for used for the design. Okay, so now how you will point it out? When you will put this value 0.22 here, then what you will get? You will get this seventh formula. That is V allowable should always be less than or equal to VD, that is the design value of velocity. Okay, now if your value of what you can say design if suppose that your value of design value of velocity is, if design value of velocity is 100 kmph, okay, 100 kmph, then your allowable can be 110 kmph, right? If your design value is 100 kmph, then allowable can be 110 or 120. Now from where this we have find out the allowable value? By using this formula. You put this 0.22 in this formula, that is your E plus F is equal to V square by 127R. Solving it, integrating it, you will get this thing. So derivation no one will ask you, but the formula and conditions will be asked in the examination. So that's why this type of conditions are important. That is, your design value should be less than or equal to allowable value. Allowable means you cannot go beyond this value. You cannot go beyond the allowable value. If your allowable value is 100 kmph, then your design value should be 90 kmph on an average. Okay, so this type of small formulas are always helpful while designing the your super elevation also. Okay, now how to design the super elevation? There are four steps in the super elevation design. For the specification of super elevation for a highway. And that steps we have discussed in our last lecture. In very detail we have discussed all these things. Okay, so that's why I am just summarizing all the things. I am not going into the derivation. In last time we have also seen the small derivation for all this. But I am just writing here the important formulas as far as your exam is considered. Okay, so I hope that you got up to this. Now after that, the next formula, important formula, eighth formula that we can derive from this is, when you are having the horizontal curve, then what will happen? In the horizontal curve, there is a radius, and that radius is nothing but radius of curvature. So the limiting value for that radius of curvature, that is the R minimum, is equal to, again from the same formula we can derive it, V square divided by 127 into E plus F. So this is the formula. Again, we can derive from this fourth formula. The minimum value of radius, how it should be, that you can derive. Okay. So what is this all about? This all about is the, what you can say, your this is all about the important formulas. Then next formula that we can have is the formula, or what you can say, condition for E. For hilly roads, we can prevent this value less than equal to 0.1. For mountainous road, or you can say hilly road only. Okay. Hilly road or mountainous road, you can say. Without snow. So without snow, you can have this value. Now, why this value should be less than 0.1? Because in hilly roads, you need to provide the more super elevation, right? Because of the safety of the vehicles, there are the steep curves, and that's why your value of super elevation can be equal to or less than 0.1. So this is the condition. After that, we have also seen the formulas for the extra widening. Now, what is the extra widening that we have seen in detail in our yesterday's lecture? But still, I will point it out, the formulas. So this is a curve road, and this is what you can say your extra widening. So there are basically two types of extra widening that we have seen. One is the WM and one is the WPS. WM is the your mechanical widening. This is the your mechanical widening, and this is the your psychological widening. Okay. So these are the two things that we have seen, and the formula for your mechanical widening. That is WM is equal to NL square by 2R. Now, N is nothing but your number of lanes, and L is the length of wheelbase. If this is your wheel, then L is the length of wheelbase. R is the again radius of circular curve. Okay, so R will be your radius of circular curve. L is the length of wheelbase. and that might be given in your numerical. If you are finding the WM value, that is the mechanical widening, then all these values must be there in your numerical. Okay, they will ask you to find the one unknown value, any one unknown value. Okay, now what is the mechanical widening and what is the psychological widening? WPS is nothing but psychological widening, that we have seen in very much detail in our previous lecture. So I will not repeat these things because already we have seen in previous lecture. So I will just recall the formula. So the formula for your WPS is V divided by 9.5 into root R. So this is the formula for your psychological widening. And W will be your total widening, and that total widening will be the addition of these two things. Okay, so this W will be your total widening, or you can say WE, you can point it out, that is the extra widening. So WE will be WM plus WPS. So these are the basic 10 formulas that you can point it out. Okay, one more formula that you can write it out here, one more formula, and that formula is also derived formula. That derived formula is also there, and I will just write it here. For the V allowable, now how much should be the value of V allowable? We have seen that V allowable, if V allowable is 100 kmph, then V design should be 90 kmph, right? Then based on what formula you can find out the V allowable? We can put this E plus F is equal to 0.22 in the fourth formula. And after having the derivation, we will get this formula, that is under root of 27 point. Now this is an empirical formula. This is a derived empirical formula, 27.94 multiplied by the capital R. Again, the radius of your curvature. So this is the again formula that I can write it here. So now these 10 formulas are what you can say very much important as far as our all numericals are considered. Okay. So that's why it is advised that all students write these formulas on your notebook, or you may take a screenshot of this. Okay. So now we will move towards the another section, and that section belongs to your transition curves. Transition curves also we have seen in our previous lecture. So again, I will just recall it. So basically we have seen the three types of transition curves. So in our previous lecture, we have also seen, but I will just recall it. This is our lemniscate. This is our spiral. This is our cubic parabola. These are the three basic types. Now, what is the transition curve that we have seen? If your two curves are there, right? If suppose that two curves are there, you need to find one combined curve for these two curves, then you will join this type of two curves. Then that curve will become a compound curve. Okay, this one is the simple curve, joining the two curves become the compound curve, and providing the smoothness to this curve, you will have the special alignments for that curve, and that can be your transition curve, and that transition curve can be of three types: lemniscate, spiral, and cubic parabola. Okay, so in hilly region, when you are having a U type of turn, whenever you are having a U type of turn, then you can prefer this lemniscate curve, right? In hilly region where you are going under a very steep slope, then you can prefer this spiral curve. And for having the smooth transition over the horizontal curve, you can implement this cubic parabola curve. Okay, so as a civil engineer, as a what you can say structural designer, or you are designing geometric elements, or what you can say geometric alignment of the highways, then you can suggest this type of designs to your alignment of the highways. Okay, so one should have the deep knowledge of all this, because all these things are included in the your standard of course, that is the IRC codes. So we follow the IRC code to suggest all these things. So transition curve can be calculated by the three methods, and all these three methods we have seen in our previous class, but still I will introduce these things to you again. We will summarize this thing. So our first method is the your rate of centrifugal acceleration. This is the first method that we have seen, and we have seen the formula for length of transition curve also, and that formula is 0.0215 divided by CR. This formula we have seen multiplied by V cube. Okay, so again the value of velocity is in your kmph. The value of C, that is the constant, can be found out by using the empirical formula, that is 80 divided by 75 plus V. So this value of C you will get, and the unit of C. Now again, this type of questions can be asked in your GATE examination. This C value you will put here, the value of R. Now R is the radius of your circular curve. Remember this thing. R is the radius of circular curve, not the transition curve, because the transition curve is having the varying radius. Which one of the following statement is true in case of the transition curve? This type of question can also be asked in your multiple choice questions. Okay. So the value of radius of the transition curve varies from the infinity to the minimum value. As you can see here, in case of the spiral curve, you can see, firstly, the value of radius is infinite. Then gradually it is reducing, and it is going towards the minimum value in case of spiral curve. Okay, so spiral curve is also a transition curve. So this thing is true with the case of transition curve, that its value of radius varies from infinity towards the minimum value. So this is our first method to calculate the length of transition curve. LS is nothing but length of transition curve. V is the velocity of your moving vehicle, or the design velocity of your highway. 0.0215 is just a multiplication factor. C is the constant. Constant can be calculated by using this formula, 80 divided by 75 plus V. Again, V is in kmph, and you will get the value of LS, that is the length of transition curve, length of this curve required in your geometric design. So this is the first method. Now, the second method to calculate transition
curve, length of transition curve is LS is equal to EN by 2 or 0.5 multiplied by EN. EN by 2. Okay. Now, what is the value of E and what is the value of N? N is nothing but your rate of super elevation. The value will lie in 1 is to N. What is the value of E? E is nothing but used for the extra widening. And extra widening, or you can say E is the value through which your inner camber is rotated. Okay. Now, what is the formula for your slope? Formula for your slope is dy by dx, right? Or tan of theta. Now, when you will multiply this with the your horizontal value, that is the dx. Okay. So, when you will multiply the dy by dx by x value is the horizontal width of the road, then this xx will get cancelled and you will get the value of dy. Okay. Now, why I am writing here? I am just summarizing these things. You will get this value of vertical elevation. Okay. Means the height through which your camber is rotated in vertical direction. This you will get. So the value of E will be small e multiplied by your W. W is the width of your pavement, this width, plus width of the your extra widening. And the formula for extra widening we have seen in our previous section, right? The value of extra widening we have seen. Extra widening is equal to WM plus WPS. That is mechanical widening plus psychological widening. What is mean by mechanical widening, psychological widening, that we have seen in our previous lecture. So I will not repeat it. Now the width of your carriageway, or we can say pathway, this is DX. DX means W here, that is the width, plus extra widening, that is the WE. Now you are multiplying it with the your slope, and slope is nothing but dy by dx. Okay, so the xx will get cancelled. Okay, so therefore this value will get cancelled and you will get this vertical height, that is the dy, and dy will be your capital E now. Okay, so understand which thing will get cancelled here. The denominator will get cancelled here with the this value, x value in this formula, and therefore you will get capital E. So what will be the value of capital E? Capital E will be the height at which your camber is raised. So that value of capital E, again you want to multiply, you have to multiply it with N by 2 so that you will get the length of transition curve. Now why this formula and from where it came? This is because the formula is the empirical formula, and this second type is based on the your rate of introduction of super elevation. Okay, so in bracket, I will write it here E, that this second thing is derived from the rate of your super elevation through which it is introduced. Okay, now third empirical formula is based on the your IRC standards. Now there are certain standards set by the IRC, and based on this, we can derive the third formula. That is, your LS is equal to 2.7 multiplied by V square upon R. So again, this is a third formula. You know that V is nothing but velocity, design velocity. Okay. So this is for your, what you can say, plane terrain. This is for plane terrain only. Okay. So in third section, you are having the two formulas. This is the first formula, sub formula. And second sub formula you are having for hilly road or mountainous road. And that formula is LS is equal to only V square by R. So the 2.7 will be eliminated from this. So this will be for your hilly road or mountainous road. Okay. So this is the second sub formula in the third empirical formula. So I hope that you have got the revision. Now this is the thing that we have covered, all the thing in our yesterday's lecture. Okay. So yesterday, few students were present. So that's why I have repeated this thing. And now we will start the main topic. And that is the vertical curves. So this is our today's important topic, that vertical curves. So vertical curves basically are of two types. So first one is the summit curve. And second one is the valley curve. Now this summit curve is also called as the crest, because it is the convex in shape, crest curve. And valley curve are also called as the sag, because they are the concave in shape. Okay. Now this summit curve, what is the formula basically used for the summit curve? You are having the equation of parabola, because these curves are parabolic in nature. This is the convex curve. So the formula is same, that of the the formula we use for the parabolic equation, that is y is equal to ax square. And here the value of a, which is the constant, can be derived from, means it is actually not the constant, it is the multiplication factor. So the value of this multiplication factor is capital N by 2L. And the N is nothing but your deviation angle in radian. So this is your angle in radians. And L is nothing but your length of curve.